This SOLIDWORKS tutorial on the essentials of basic machine design shows you the A to Z of a real-life engineering project through the eyes of a pro-level user. But will he finish before the snowboarder gets to the bottom of the mountain? Hi, it's Cliff. Quick recap on the story so far. At the start of my engineering career, I noticed that the best engineers I met all seemed to be masters at SOLIDWORKS. So, I decided to make my number one priority to get great at SOLIDWORKS and attend as much training as possible, as well as not shying away from trying challenging new things in SOLIDWORKS. Problem is that SOLIDWORKS was elusive to me and I felt helpless. I didn't know where to start and what to do. Thanks to the help of a talented SOLIDWORKS user who shared a cubicle wall with me, I was at an acceptable level in my SOLIDWORKS journey after about 6 months. I was hired as the engineering manager at a renewable energy firm because of my SOLIDWORKS expertise. I got to attend some more SOLIDWORKS training, slightly better but still eons away from anything useful in the real world. Now, I was getting paid better and I began to achieve real results for the company. Showed them what a project and engineering drawing should look like from start to finish from a manufacturing perspective. I took the company from making 1% to 8% margins in the next 3 months by implementing lean manufacturing principles using my knowledge of SOLIDWORKS. Then the unthinkable happened. I got fired twice because I couldn't get the ideas in my head out onto SOLIDWORKS. I was so frustrated. I even ended up splitting with my girlfriend of 5 years. You'll never guess what I did next. I'll get to that shortly. First, I want to show you this. For SOLIDWORKS users who are dissatisfied with the steep learning curve to get your ideas into SOLIDWORKS, this tutorial on the essentials of basic machine design shows you the A to Z of a real-life engineering project through the eyes of a pro-level user. And unlike most 3-day courses, which will cost you upwards of $2,000, it will make you quicker, more efficient, and more effective. Now, here's another question from our recent survey. What are the subjects covered in your Essentials program? Well, you'll learn how to set up drawings and link drawing and part templates, customize title blocks, create your design intent, the hidden connections between lean manufacturing and VFX, use sheet metal, use toolbox, advanced assembly, exploded views, section of purchased parts, bill of materials, raw material choices, number assemblies. SOLIDWORKS drawing of the motor gearbox from the Essentials of Basic Machine Design course. Keep watching. Full animation coming soon. Now, there's a real possibility that this program may not be for you. If you are someone who shies away from trying challenging new things or is only interested in engineering theory, better go talk to a peer academic or spend $2,000 on a theoretical course. But if you're an engineer who genuinely wants to roll up your sleeves and apply the tips, tricks, and shortcuts to master SOLIDWORKS that only a practiced and skilled pro user who designs in SOLIDWORKS every day can show you, this course is for you. We will give you an unfair advantage when it comes to your next job interview. Because after I got fired the second time, I went snowboarding, and halfway down the mountain, on the steepest part of the course, I had an epiphany. I knew that I simply had to develop the best SOLIDWORKS course available to show you a real-world engineering project and get the ideas in your head out into SOLIDWORKS. The Essentials of Basic Machine Design course is 5 hours and 21 minutes of high-definition video and complete model, downloadable from our website. We have also set up a closed group on Facebook where you can compare notes with other engineers who have purchased the course and ask us any questions to clarify or mentor you through the learning process. It's literally like having an expert sitting next to you, and the course is priced at only $147. And it gets better. for the launch period only, because I want to get your feedback, testimonials, and case studies, I'm offering a special price of $77 until midnight on Saturday, February 28th. To secure your download of the Essentials of Basic Machine Design course, click on the link below to buy with one clip. And as I promised, the animation from the course is coming. Thank you for watching this video series. Click the link below to secure your Essentials of Basic Machine Design course download and exclusive access to our closed Facebook group at the special price of $77. Offer ends at midnight on February 28th.
Hi everyone, and welcome to this tutorial brought to you by Solidworks Zen. Okay, this tutorial is about conveyor design, and this is a particular conveyor designed to take the boxes that are flat on the belt and make them stand upright for filling purposes or whatever have you. Okay, then we're going to, after we've designed the conveyor and shown you how it's done, we're going to make drawings, engineering drawings of the parts and the assemblies in the conveyor, and afterwards we're going to show you an animation of how this conveyor would work. We'll also tell you how to make this animation using SolidWorks animation, and that's just about it. Okay, some of the things I'll be talking about in this tutorial are generally related to conveyor design, which won't be specifically to this design, but in general for all the conveyors. And some of the things that would be specifically for this conveyor. Okay, now we have our start condition. We're going to start making this conveyor from a point where you know what needs to be done in terms of the starting conditions, like you have your box somewhere around at this point. You know where this point is. You know where your box ends up after it has been stood upright, and you have selected a motor. Now this motor I've used for this purpose is just for demonstration purposes only, and I've taken this motor from the link that you'll be seeing at the bottom right now. And obviously, to make this conveyor work, your starting condition for the box and the ending condition for the box have to have a height difference. This height difference is required for this star wheel assembly that actually does the work for the conveyor and makes the box stand upright. It takes feed from this conveyor and throws the box on this conveyor in the upright position. Sorry. Okay. Also, let's look at the features that I've used on the motor. Now, after downloading the motor from the link, I've actually combined the bodies in the motor. That's all the bodies that you'll see in the file. Then afterwards, I have purposely scaled this motor to make it smaller. Here you can see that it's uniform scaling around the centroid, and this is the value I've used. I've used this particular value for the scale to round off the dimensions that I have for this motor and its mounting. Let's change the units to inches, and you can see that it's about 3.63 inches, this motor, for the purpose of mounting. Just for demonstration purposes, in actual you'll be making your conveyor around the dimensions of the motor and how it's going to get mounted on the conveyor. That would be your starting step. Also, another important point is to know the dimensions of the box that you're going to be transferring. For this particular tutorial, I'm going to be using a box that has a dimension of 12 inches by 7 3/4 inches, and the thickness of the box is 2 inches. Later on, I'll show you the box as well. And okay, now we can begin making this conveyor.